Okay, so our next speaker, where are we headed? We're headed to registered dietitian. Linda Pataki, registered dietitian, and Angela Snyder here at Houston Methodist Hospital.
Good afternoon. My name's Angela Snyder. I'm a registered dietitian. I work in wellness services as well as our cardiac rehab program. Linda and I are going to talk to you a little bit today about the diet portion. We know it's such an important part of heart failure and managing heart failure, and so we're going to give you a few tips specifically about savvy shopping. We want the majority of your meals to be eaten at home because that way you know what's in your food and you know the sodium that you're getting. Whenever you eat out, those sodium numbers do go up. That doesn't mean you can't eat out, but we do want you to have, ideally, the majority of your meals at home so that you can control the salt and the sodium that you're eating. So just a few quick tips. We know, first of all, I always like to tell people, the average American eats about 3,000 to 4,000 milligrams of sodium a day, so we know that asking you to eat around 2,000 milligrams can be challenging. So we know that, and hopefully some of these tips can help you. So the first one is to just make sure that you stock your pantry with the essentials that you need. So often we get in a hurry, we come home, we don't know what's for dinner. If you've got those essentials in your pantry, it'll be much easier to put a healthy meal together. Also, ideally, you're planning for your week. Whenever we are able to plan out our meals and have our recipes ready and have the healthy foods ready, it makes it so much easier to come together. If you're running late and you don't know what's for dinner, that's whenever those sort of high sodium foods can come in because we look for convenience foods. So if you're planning, we want you to keep a list. We want you to have a menu. We want you to have an idea of what you're doing at the beginning of the week. Also, keep a running grocery list as well next to you whenever you're at home. So if you run out of an essential, you have a list where you can keep it. We do want you to shop with a list as well because we know the grocery stores tend to put those tempting, maybe unhealthy items there on the end cap or somewhere else tempting in the store. So shop with a list and shop at times also that aren't busy. I feel like whenever the grocery store is busy, there's so much going on, you don't really have time to stop and read labels and analyze the food in the way that you need to whenever you do feel rushed. So keep that in mind. Try to mostly shop the perimeter of the store. Whenever you think about how a grocery store is laid out, we have our fruits and vegetables, we have our fresh seafood and meat, you have your dairy. That's what's on the perimeter of the grocery store. Typically, what's going to be in the middle is more of the processed, higher sodium food, your canned vegetables, your chips, your pretzels, those sorts of dry goods. So just think about that. We want the majority of your food to be coming from the perimeter and especially from the fresh and frozen produce departments. And then lastly, just make sure you're focusing on those fresh, whole foods. We tell you that we want half of your plate to be fruits and vegetables. So translate that into half of your grocery cart also being fruits and vegetables. So you can't just pick up a few bananas and a bag of salad for the week if we want half of your plate to consistently be fruits and vegetables during the week. And then next, I think this is a great visual. This is from the American Heart Association. They've listed what they call the salty six. So the thing you have to realize is the majority of the salt we're getting in our diet is coming from processed foods. It's not coming, we aren't just, you know, a lot of us aren't just pouring salt on our food. It's coming from processed foods. So the American Heart Association found that these were the top six high salt foods that Americans were consuming. So just keep that in mind whenever you do go to the grocery store and whenever you do read labels. So breads and rolls, we don't necessarily think about that because it's not a salty food. But just because of the leavening agent that's required in these, and they do add a little bit of salt, a lot of salt is coming from that in our diet. Cold cuts and cured meats, so any kind of lunch meat, any kind of bacon, even healthy turkey bacon. This is obviously going to contain a lot of sodium. Sandwiches, because we put the salty bread with the salty lunch meat and some salty cheese. So that one may be a little obvious. Also pizza, because think about the salty cheese that's going into your pizza as well as potentially a processed meat. And then the pasta sauce and the red sauce that goes in that as well. Any kind of soup can be salty, especially obviously if it's processed or pre-made. And then lastly, chicken. Again, this may be an area we don't think about being very salty, but there are some, there is some raw chicken that they put it in a salty solution whenever you buy it. So I do want you to check your labels on that. And the other source that seems to be pretty prominent is those rotisserie chickens that are at the grocery store and at Sam's and Costco. I know they're easy to grab. I know they're convenient, but they do brine them, and there is a lot of salt in those. So keep an eye out for that whenever you're buying your chicken and your poultry. And then Linda's going to come now and talk to you a little bit just about the food label. No?
Got it. Hi, I'm Linda Pataki, and I'm a clinical dietitian here at Methodist. And I'm going to talk a little bit about the food label. And the first thing that I want to mention is the portion size on the label, because the portion size may or may not be the portion size that you're normally eating. But the portions, the nutrients that are listed on the label are based on that portion size. So that if you're used to eating a cup and a third, but the portion size they list on the label is 2/3 cup, then you have to double everything on the label, the sodium content, the fat content. The second thing I want to talk about is the percent daily value. The percent daily value is based on 2,000 calories, which may or may not be appropriate for you personally. What it does do is it provides you with guidelines for the fat content. So look for foods that contain less than 30% of the total calories coming from fat, and less than 10% of the calories coming from saturated fat. Sodium content really depends on whether you're eating the food for a meal or an entree, or you're eating it for a snack. The little rule of thumb that I like to use is if you're eating the food item for a meal, it should be in the neighborhood of 500 milligrams of sodium. In other words, a meal should contain approximately 500 milligrams of sodium per serving. And if it's a snack, it's about 250 milligrams of sodium per serving. So that's just a little guideline. And that can vary depending on your meals. You might eat a little bit more for one meal. You might eat a little bit less for another. Other things that you want to look for on a label are whether the fats are hydrogenated or there are a lot of trans fats on the label or in the food item. That would be listed on the label. Whether there's a lot of high fructose corn syrup, which can raise serum triglyceride levels. Again, a little guideline that is easy to use is the more ingredients a food item has, the more processed the food item is. So try and look for foods that contain five ingredients or less. And finally, another little rule of thumb, if you're selecting foods that contain an equal amount of sugar and fiber, you're doing better because that means that it's less processed. So thank you very much.